Tesla's 4860 battery, EV game changer, or hype? What if I say that the key to transforming electric vehicles was hidden in a battery? Join us to unravel the mystery of Tesla's 4860 battery, a potential game changer in the EV world. Technological advancements have become necessary in the rapidly evolving landscape of electric vehicles, EVs. Tesla, led by the visionary Elon Musk, is among the most significant contributors to this sector. Recently, Musk announced a groundbreaking development in EV technology, introducing the new 4860 battery. This groundbreaking innovation stands ready to redefine the EV industry. In this video, we'll delve into the nuances of this new battery, exploring its potential to transform Tesla's position, particularly the much-anticipated Cybertruck. Imagine a vehicle that, along with turning heads with its futuristic design, also packs a punch with unmatched performance. That's Tesla's Cybertruck for you. This electric pickup truck is the future of electric vehicles. The Cybertruck's promise of high performance and durability has already become the recent talk of the market, but the show's real star is its potential integration with Tesla's groundbreaking 4860 battery technology in this vehicle, which makes it so special. But why? Let's discover. We'll start by discussing how the initial 2020 version of the 4860 battery was downgraded initially and then upgraded recently, and also compare it with its predecessor, the 2170 battery. In 2020, when Tesla first announced the 4860 battery, despite the initial excitement, it soon became clear that the battery wasn't quite ready for widespread use. One of the main challenges with the initial 4860 battery was achieving an optimal balance between energy density, the amount of energy stored in a given system per unit volume, and efficiency. In simpler terms, energy density measures how much power can be stored in a given space. Higher energy density means more power, and more power means longer driving ranges, without the need for frequent recharging. The 2170 battery, used in many of Tesla's vehicles, had set a high standard in the industry. Its energy density was reported to be around 250 watt-hours per kilogram. This level of energy density was already considered high, allowing Tesla's vehicles to achieve impressive ranges. The 4860 battery was expected to significantly exceed this, with Tesla aiming for a 30% increase in energy density. This would put the 4860 battery's target energy density at around 325 watt-hours per kilogram. However, the initial versions of the 4860 battery did not meet these ambitious targets. While the exact numbers on the initial energy density of the 4860 battery were not publicly disclosed, it was clear from Tesla's continued development and refinement efforts that the battery had fallen short of expectations. The main consequence of not achieving the targeted energy density was the potential driving range. Tesla's goal with the 4860 battery was to significantly increase the range of their EVs, making them even more competitive with gasoline vehicles and appealing to a broader market. Tesla's reputation as a leader in EV technology meant high expectations for the 4860 battery. The initial shortfall in energy density was a setback in terms of market expectations and Tesla's own goals for EV advancement. Another significant issue was related to the manufacturing process. The 4860 battery's innovative design posed new production challenges. For EV batteries, consistent quality is non-negotiable. In the early stages, producing the 4860 with uniform quality was a challenge. The failure rate during manufacturing was initially higher, leading to increased waste and cost. For instance, a typical failure rate of 5% in battery production might have been acceptable, but with the complexities of the 4860, this rate was significantly higher, impacting overall efficiency and output. But the real issue is still yet to be revealed. What could that be? If you're as curious as we are, hit that subscribe button and stay with us to get updated and be the first one to know about market innovations. The 4860 battery's innovative design necessitated using advanced materials and developing specialized manufacturing equipment. These materials and equipment were expensive and scarce, representing cutting-edge technology not yet widely available in the market. For instance, the cost of unique lithium compounds or advanced electrode materials was several times higher than that of traditional batteries. Moreover, significant investment went into the research and development, R&D, of the 4860 battery. For example, if typical R&D costs for a new battery technology range from $50 to $100 million, Tesla's innovative approach likely pushed these figures even higher. When new technology is first produced, it often suffers from low yields, the percentage of products manufactured correctly without defects. Low yields mean more materials and time are needed to produce a usable product, increasing costs. The initial rate for the 4860 battery was significantly lower than for more established battery types, pushing production costs higher. To address these challenges, Tesla embarked on a journey of refinement and innovation, which will make your jaws drop. We'll be looking at some changes that will distinguish this battery from all other traditional batteries. So, are you ready to unravel the future of EV batteries with us? First of all, moving away from the standard large pouch-styled cells, Tesla opted for a cylindrical tabless electrode cobalt-free design. Why go cylindrical and tabless? Here's the catch. The cylindrical shape of the 4860 battery is a masterstroke in design efficiency. It shortens lithium ions' journey from the cathode to the anode. This reduction in distance means less resistance and, crucially, less heat generation, two significant obstacles in traditional battery design. The outcome? A seamless flow of electrons ensures a cooler and more efficient battery operation, far surpassing the capabilities of the previous 2170 model. This is an upgrade that completely overhauls the way we think about battery design. Diving deeper into the 4860 battery, we find its anode made from raw metallurgical silicone. Unlike the commonly used silicon in the industry, this material doesn't crack under the stress of energy flow. Enhanced with an elastic ion-coating polymer, the anode's durability skyrockets, promising longevity and reliability. The cathode sees a revolutionary shift, too. Tesla boldly moves away from cobalt, a mainstay in most EV batteries, but fraught with ethical and environmental concerns. Instead, they embrace a nickel-manganese combination. This switch alleviates ethical dilemmas and also amps up the battery's range by an impressive 16%. It's a win-win in performance and sustainability. Now, get ready for some eye-popping numbers. The 4860 battery possesses a staggering 5x increase in energy density and a 6x surge in power output compared to its predecessors, the 2170 batteries. These numbers represent a shift in EV technology, unlocking longer driving ranges and performance. Imagine EVs that can travel further and charge faster. That's the promise of the 4860 battery, and nothing could be better demanded than this in the EV industry. We can now clearly comprehend the upcoming future of batteries and the most demanded car of the season, and meet its ambitious production targets, the 4860 ultimately could be the choke point in CEO Musk's dream of building 20 million vehicles annually by 2030. Otherwise, this would remain a dream as it had been for several years past. So what do you think? Will Tesla be able to capture the market this time with its 4860 battery, or is it, again, a failed attempt? Comment your thoughts and don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like this video if you enjoyed the journey.